Guys, so this is my house. I don't know what to do.
Oh my God!
Day 4 of the U.S. winter weather crisis, and things only seem to be getting worse, especially in Texas, where as of Thursday afternoon, a 500,000 people are still without power and heat as electricity companies fail to deal with rare sub-zero temperatures.
Got the shower on hot, and I got about 10 jackets on, and I don't think I'm gonna make it no more. So who got heat at their house, bro? I'm coming over.
A quarter of the residents in the state have been told to boil their own drinking water as supply systems are hit. Adding insult to injury, a state famous for its oil industry is also suffering from a shortage of petrol.
We're kind of stuck here. I have 9 miles left to go with my car, so we have to find something that's within 9 miles from here.
Texas is America's second most populous state, with 29 million residents living in an area larger than the whole of France. It's the only U.S. state that has its own electricity grid and is not part of the national system by its own choice, which has allowed it to bypass federal regulations designed to protect against exactly these kinds of conditions. Under fire for being seemingly woefully unprepared, the state's energy bosses were forced to defend themselves.
It was a problem with that capacity being knocked out by an extraordinary event, and also the impact that that same extraordinary event had on gas supplies and obviously on load. I'm sure people may argue about that once we're done.
Also facing scrutiny, Texas Republican Senator Ted Cruz, who on Wednesday left his embattled state for an unannounced family vacation in the Mexican beach resort of Cancun. When outrage ensued, he promptly cut his trip short and flew home.
The storm is now here over the northeast of the U.S., and it's forecast to linger until the end of Friday. But it is not expected to cause nearly as much disruption as what it has in Texas, a state that remains in a deep freeze crisis. Gabriel Elizondo, Al Jazeera, New York.